stats. We know them, we love them, we need them. We've had 6 unique stats since Shadowkeep in 2019 that offer different ways to build your monster slaying or player slaying machine. But what do they actually do? Are some stats superior than others? If you're hearing this, maybe you have a question like this. So let's take a look, shall we? You've got 10 tiers for each stat, with higher tiers being more desirable depending on your playstyle and or class. Increasing tiers can provide a consistent increase for some stats, while others provide higher benefits for higher tiers. Some stats also work concurrently with decreasing your class ability cooldown depending on your class. You increase your tier by reaching 10 points in a stat, with a maximum of 100. Anything over that results in wasted stats, no bonuses, but you do acquire Omega Alpha status. It is very possible to get multiple 100 stats if you can get lucky with stats on your armor, but more on that in a bit. Anyway, let's get into these 6 choices you have. Mobility, probably the weakest of the 6. Increases walking, strafing speed, and initial jump height. So sprinting and class-specific jumps like gliding are not affected. Mobility also affects the cooldown of Hunter's dodge ability, so spec into this if you like rolling around. Resilience, much more important than it once was, increases your damage resistance and reduces stasis breakout damage. Last year, how much flinch resistance you have also became affected by your resilience stat. It also affects the cooldown of Titan's barricade ability, so spec into this if you like plopping walls. Recovery, always been good, decreases the delay before your health starts regenerating after taking damage and increases your health recovery speed. Recovery also affects the cooldown of Warlock's Rift ability, so spec into this if you like plopping rifts. Discipline, if you like grenades, this will let you throw them more. Intellect, if you like popping your big shiny powers more often, this will help you pop them more. And Strength, if you like getting up close and personal, this will get your charged melee up more. What you want most of wholly depends on what sort of build or content you're running. For example, for most PvE content, resilience is a go-to stat because damage resistance. Another example is recovery in PvP. Being able to recover faster and get back into the fray is highly useful. For ability stats, again, it wholly depends on your playstyle and what you want more of. Want more nades? Discipline. Supers? Intellect. Melees? Strength. Now, let's give some more practical examples with the help of everyone's favorite Colossus. I'll be suggesting to pause to read if you would like at certain obvious points. Let's take a look at resilience first. For this, we'll look at how a few different tiers will affect your gameplay. Yes, this isn't high-end stuff where you'll get absolutely obliterated, but this will still show a difference in tiers. Now, when stomped at tiers 1, 5, and 10, you can see a difference in how much damage is taken. And for extra reference, here is each tier. Pause to read. So yes, you would very much want to consider this. On to recovery, which compared to Resil offers a much larger jump at higher tiers. Here, I use the same Resil of tier 7 at recov tiers 1, 6, and 10 for a fair test since tier 6 is about half of tier 10 compared to tier 5. And I do whittle myself down to about the same health, again, for a fair test. Here, you can definitely notice the speed difference across these few tiers. And I'll now show the tier progress. Pause to read. So yeah, big jumps, very valuable, especially for Warlocks. More on that soon. On to mobility. The lower tiers don't show too much of a difference in jump height, but those higher tiers are way more noticeable. Similarly, for walking, you feel pretty speedy at tier 10. These tiers show that. Pause to read. Next, your abilities. Grenades, supers, melees, and class abilities all have base cooldowns, seen when hovering over one in your inspection menu, and are at different tiers. Here is some lists of each tier, and their cooldown. Big pause to read here. Are you back? Okay, cool. Hi. At a tier 3 stat, you will notice that it will be the same as the base cooldown, so try to be tier 3 or higher at least. For grenades, melees, and class abilities, I tested tiers 1, 5, and 10. And for supers, I use tiers 2, 5, and 10, because tier 1 is just incredibly long. For nades, we'll use a Glacier and Arcbolt nade as examples, which are in tier 1 and tier 3 cooldowns, respectively. As usual, having a higher tier is nice, but grenades and melees do be having smaller increases due to lower overall cooldowns. But having those lower cooldowns is still quite valuable and could be the difference between being overwhelmed and surviving an encounter. Pause to read if you haven't already. For melees, we will use Shiver Strike and Thunderclap in tier 1 and 3 cooldowns respectively. Similar to grenades, melees only have small increases but can still make a difference in situations. Pause to read. With supers, I used Marksman Goldie in tier 2 cooldown and Deadfall Shadow Shot in tier 4. As seen, those lower tiers are way slower, with higher tiers offering smaller increases, but since supers can be gotten so quickly now, with receiving and dealing damage as well as millions of orbs, a mid-range intellect or even slightly below is fine. With class abilities, these cooldowns scale with different abilities for each class as mentioned previously. Besides rifts, each dodge and barricade have different cooldowns, as well as Phoenix Dive for warlocks. I use Gambler's Dodge, Healing Rift, which will be the same for empowering, and Towering Barricade as examples. Generally, if the ability has a higher base cooldown, it'll see slightly bigger jumps in tiers than lower base cooldowns. Fortunately, for Warlocks and Titans, you'll most likely have your Rift or Wall up more often, since Resilience and Recovery are a staple for any class. Unlike Hunters, where mobility is not that special. Bungie, please do something about mobility, I'm begging you. But Dodge cooldown is already much lower than other class abilities, so having a mid-range mobility tier should do the job nicely for most players. And as always, pause if you haven't already. And that ends the digital tour of tier examples for each stat. Hopefully you're still alive and with me. Or maybe you already skipped to this point, and in that case, you're definitely still kicking. Now, I'll try not to liquefy your brains again. Stats are split into two subgroups. Mobility, Resilience, and Recovery in the first group. Discipline, Intellect, and Strength in the second. For each subgroup, the total amount of point allocation maxes out at 34. So overall, 68 is the max amount of points on a base legendary piece of armor. To break this down, the lowest any stat can go is 2. So if you had two stats at plus 2, the highest the third one could go is plus 30 to equal 34. Similarly, the highest two stats could be is 16 and the third 2 to make 34. Masterworking a piece of armor will increase each stat by 2, so you'll go to a max of 80. But then you can further increase your max by applying a plus 5 or plus 10 stat mod in your first mod slot, increasing to 90. And then, yes, this is a lot, I know. If you have Artifice Armor from Master Dungeons, you can add a plus 3 armor mod to finally increase your max to 93. Exotic Armor is basically the same, minus the plus 3 Artifice slot, but its base stats can drop to a max of 70 instead of 68, like what you're seeing now. 30 is still the max in one stat, but the other two in the same subgroup can be a plus 3. So Masterworking and then adding a stat mod will give an exotic piece a max of 92 points. Obviously, this is not your everyday piece, so you'll most often be optimizing with, on average, mid-60 base armor, or maybe even low-60 depending on RNG or what you play. And having Artifice Armor is not mandatory in the slightest, you can still very possibly get something like double 100 stats without it. So how do we actually get these high stats? Gaining stats comes from two main sources, mainly your worn armor and additionally your subclass fragments. Blues will be at the most low-50s. Legendary armor is where you will start to get higher stats. From random world drops, legendary and prime engrams, and most activities like ritual playlists, you'll likely only be getting on average mid-50s overall. Armor with higher overall stats will come from content like raids, dungeons, trials, iron banner, and seasonal content. This isn't always guaranteed, however, so bear that in mind. Raids and dungeons should always drop high armor IMO, like PvP. Seasonal content does usually drop high stat armor too if you don't have a fire team for the other stuff. This includes activity completions and focusing at the vendor in the helm. Exotic armor can drop with many random numbers, with collections always being those low amounts, and then random activity rewards and engram drops being higher. As mentioned previously, subclass fragments are also a way of gaining more stats. Some fragments will offer stat increases, with some also decreasing stats, most often by 10 either way, but Echo of Undermining on Void will minus 20 discipline. There is also a way to affect the stat distribution, and that is through Armor of Ghost mods. They aren't as straightforward, so let's go through them quickly. In the economic mod slot, you have Ghost Armorer mods, one for each stat. These mods will guarantee 10 in the desired stat and will more likely roll higher in that desired stat. But what mod should you pick? As said previously, stats are divided into two groups. So for example, since resilience and recovery are very coveted, you should choose an armorer mod out of the other subgroup, that is discipline, intellect, or strength. Most players would likely choose discipline since intellect got adjusted a lot many months ago, and unless you're running a strength build, grenades are much more desirable than melees. So, choosing a discipline mod will guarantee it to have at least 10 points and potentially higher points, and you'll get higher stats in resilience, recovery, and mobility, unfortunately, but you will likely get some decent stats in your desired stats. Is your brain mushed yet? No? Still here? Sweet. Speaking of mods, there are also armor mods, at least one on each piece, that will increase the effectiveness of your selected stat, not permanently, as long as you have armor charge on a timer. But with how easy orbs are to make now, being able to lengthen your timer and increase how much you hold and obtain at once, you can basically have permanent boosted ability regen as long as enemies are around. Pretty neat, right? And that is a deep dive, no pun intended, into the stats we can build into. Again, pick the stats that you want. Some things are just my opinion, but really, will a mobility ever be more useful besides being somewhat needed for hunters? Anyway, build and content will determine what you need, but stats like resilience will always be a go-to unless it gets adjusted. Who knows if that will happen. If you enjoyed this or found it at all helpful, dropping a like or sub would be greatly appreciated and give you quad 100 stats. Probably. If you're curious on what weapons are intriguing at that one tower kiosk, I dare you to check this out. Do it. If you want to see something more like this or similar, let me know. But for now, I'll talk to you all later.